From where the black hole is to what it could mean for our planet and system and more. Join us as we show you the nearest black hole to Earth that's been discovered. In the vastness of space, there is no doubt that we haven't found everything that is out there. But when something we miss turns out to be a black hole that is the closest one to Earth at present, that would be something that's kind of shocking. And yet that's something that was indeed discovered in May of 2020, the closest black hole currently to Earth. The black hole, which is lurking 1,000 light years from Earth in the southern constellation of Telescopium, belongs to a system with two companion stars that are bright enough to observe with the naked eye. But you won't be able to see the black hole itself. The massive object has such a strong gravitational pull that nothing, not even light, can escape it, which is one of the trademarks of a black hole, hence why it is so hard to find them when you don't know where they are based on the darkness of space. Astronomers discovered this black hole while studying what they thought was just a binary star system, or two stars that orbit a common center of mass. They were using the MPG ESO 2.2 meter telescope at the La Silla Observatory in Chile to observe the binary known as HR 6819 as part of a broader study on double star systems. When they analyzed their observations, the researchers were shocked to learn that a third object was hiding in the system, a black hole. Could you imagine the shock? Not only did they find an interesting binary system, but they found a hidden gem, literally hiding in plain sight, with a bit of a cloak over it. Although the astronomers could not directly observe the black hole, they were able to infer its presence based on its gravitational interactions with the two other objects in the system. By observing the system for several months, they were able to map out the star's orbits and figure out that another massive unseen object must be acting in the system. Believe it or not, this process of observation has led to many discoveries, including the theory that there is a rogue object in our own solar system based on similar gravity fluctuations and disruptions in basic movements of objects. The observations also show that one of the two stars orbits the invisible object every 40 days, while the other star hangs out by itself at a much greater distance from the black hole. This is important for various reasons. First and foremost, if one star does indeed orbit the black hole every 40 days, then it's possible that the black hole is draining the star slowly as it orbits it. Black holes are able to pull just about anything into its core because of its intense gravity, and that includes a star. So over time, depending on the distance between the star and the black hole, the mass and energy of the star will be fed to the black hole, which will make the star slowly die, while it actually expands the black hole. So having a virtually never-ending supply of food via a star would be quite the catch for a black hole. And eventually, over time, they can expand to the ranks of a supermassive black hole via absorbing enough objects, and these black holes can be well over the size of galaxies. Getting back to the black hole in question, the scientist who found this one calculated that the object is a stellar mass black hole, a black hole that forms from the collapse of a dying star. That's about four times the mass of the Sun. An invisible object with a mass at least four times that of the Sun can only be a black hole. Thomas Ravinius, a scientist with the European Southern Observatory, who led the new study, said in a statement, "This system contains the nearest black hole to Earth that we know of," he added. Before we dive into the impact of that last statement, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve our content for you, the viewer. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Hearing that there is a black hole only 1,000 light years from Earth might feel somewhat disconcerting to some, but also very unimportant to others. Even if it was just one light year away, that would be quite a distance. But 1,000, that's nowhere near us in a certain scope of the galaxy we live in. For the record, a light year is about 6 trillion miles. So this black hole is 6,000 trillion miles away from us right now. For point of comparison, after HR 6819's black hole, the nearest known black hole is about 3,000 light years away from Earth in the constellation Monoceros, which would mean it's 18,000 trillion miles away from Earth. That's a long ways away. However, there still could be others lurking even closer that have yet to be detected. Astronomers estimate that there are millions of black holes in our galaxy alone. And the fact that it took until May 2020 to go and find this new black hole that was only 1,000 light years away proves once again that the universe isn't as well mapped out and known as once believed, or as expected by some people in the world. If there is one that is 1,000 light years away from Earth, what's to say that there isn't one 500 light years away, or 100, or 50, or 5? The truth is, we don't know. We're still finding out things about our own solar system, let alone the rest of our galaxy and the grander scale of the universe. Plus, as noted, the nature of black holes is one that they don't like being seen. So for all we know, there could be a small one right next door, and we wouldn't know about it until we notice things around it acting strangely. Not unlike what happened with HR 6819's black hole, which in and of itself was very special upon its discovery. The black hole in HR 6819 is one of the first stellar mass black holes found in our galaxy that does not release bright X-rays while violently interacting with its companion stars, and the discovery could help researchers find other similarly quiet black holes in the Milky Way, according to the team who found it. There must be hundreds of millions of black holes out there, but we know about only very few, Ravinia said. Knowing what to look for should put us in a better position to find them. You see, we're still learning things about black holes that we didn't know before. We expected all black holes in the Milky Way galaxy to act a certain way, and yet that clearly is not the case here. So what other surprises could we find as we look for more and more black holes out in space? Who knows? The universe is full of surprises. While you may not be able to find the black hole of HR 6819 while stargazing from your backyard, skywatchers in the southern hemisphere can see the stars in the HR 6819 system in the night sky without the help of binoculars or a telescope, which is quite a thing, as the team revealed. We were totally surprised when we realized that this is the first stellar system with a black hole that can be seen with the unaided eye. Peter Hadrava, a scientist emeritus at the Academy of Sciences of the Czech Republic in Prague, and co-author of the study, said in the statement. The duo, in terms of the stars themselves, appears as a single fifth-magnitude star in the modern constellation of Telescopium, near the border with the constellation of Pavo, the peacock. On the magnitude scale, in which smaller numbers denote brighter objects, the faintest objects visible to the human eye are at magnitude 6.5, currently shining at magnitude 5.4, just slightly brighter than Uranus, the dimmest visible planet. HR 6819 is just barely bright enough for our eyeballs, yet it is enough and thus we can look at it, and that's why many astronomers were drawn to it and wanted to see what else was there, and they found a black hole. So who knows what they'll find if they see another system that they want to explore visually. Researchers have long estimated that the Milky Way is home to hundreds of millions of black holes, but as stated, we only know of some of them, a very small number of them as a whole. That's because finding these dark objects has proven extremely difficult. Dozens of black holes in the galaxy have been spotted feeding on nearby clouds of gas, a process that emits X-rays as the material swirls around the edges of the black hole. But the majority of black holes in our galaxy are invisible, so the only way to find them is by observing their gravitational effects on surrounding objects, which is what happened here. Another reason why this particular black hole is important was because it was one that was born via a dying star, which means more than likely that HR 6819 was at one time a place with multiple stars, possibly even more than three, with the third being the star before it became a black hole. It would just depend on how long the black hole has been around, and how long it's been absorbing things in the solar system. These kinds of gaps in history is what makes astronomers want to study black holes more and more. By finding and studying them, we can learn a lot about the formation and evolution of those rare stars that begin their lives with more than about 8 times the mass of the Sun, and end them in a supernova explosion that leaves behind a black hole. And of course, by learning the history of this area, we start to slowly learn about the universe as a whole. Some black holes are stated to have been around near the beginning of the universe itself, depending on whose reports you believe. so learning even the tiniest things about black holes could help us unravel a key mystery about the universe. But let's get back to the question in regards to the closest black hole to Earth. Do we personally have anything to fear from this black hole? The answer to that is no, for now. Now, we're not trying to depress you or anything like that, we're just being honest. You see, while this particular black hole isn't affecting us right now, that doesn't mean it couldn't in the future. As stated earlier, black holes can grow and literally evolve into bigger and bigger forms. The more they grow, the more gravity they exert, and the more stuff that gets pulled into them, expanding them even more. Thus, if this particular black hole were to grow to an incredible, or even supermassive size, there is little doubt that it would affect us, eventually. The question then would be, how long is eventually? That's a bit hard to calculate because it would depend on the amount of absorption in regards to the mass of nearby objects like the two suns in its system, and how much it itself would need to go to the next level. More than likely though, by the time it would get to the size needed to affect our solar system, humanity will either be gone from the system or just gone as a whole. But again, it's important to note just how close it is in the scale of the universe. As one scientist calculated, if you were to take the distance from the Earth to the Sun and say that this was a strand of hair, then the black hole of HR 6819 would be about 4 miles away. That's both very far and yet very close. So if another black hole were to pop up on the road at some point that is closer than that one, we might have something to fear. Let's just say for argument's sake that there is a black hole only a few light years away from us. Do we have to worry? At first, more than likely not, if the size is small. It would have the same problems that HR 6819 would have. However, should it grow and its gravity be exerted and that reach hits our sun, then we would have a severe problem. Our sun is in a perfect rotation, if you will, in regards to how it's affected by the galaxy as a whole. If that is disrupted, that'll disrupt the flow of the orbits of the planets in our solar system, which would of course affect Earth. And should the gravity of the black hole start to affect the planets, potentially even luring them into an orbit around it instead of the sun, then we would quite literally be devastated. Hopefully now you can see and appreciate why it's important that we know where the closest black hole is, because it gives us a measuring stick as to how safe we are. And should another one be found that's closer, we can adjust that stick. All in all, it is very unlikely that there is a black hole near us that could affect us in any rational amount of time. But the universe has shocked us before, so why would it stop now? Thanks for watching. What did you think of this look at the newest black hole found in the universe that just so happens to be close to Earth? Do you think that we'll have to fear this black hole eventually? Do you think that there is an even closer black hole near Earth? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.